Exactly. Most of it's going to pull from the bit here. Most of it will pull from the bit that we apply. Exactly. So we're going to go for a spherical shape this time, just for variety's sake. I thought about repeating the form that we just blew, but I think for variety's sake, we're going to go for the spherical shape. Welcome, everybody. Oh, yeah, I know. I like to let the glass do its thing for a moment before I marvel my starter bubbles. I used to go straight to the steel. That's great. That's perfect, Courtney. That one's nicer than the one I made, so we might use that one. So for those of you that don't know what I've been making lately, I've been working on a series of plumb bobs. Anyway, I'm enamored with the forms. I'm not necessarily mimicking, but playing off the variety of forms that plumb bobs have been made in throughout history. It can cover it, that's fine. We'll check out the diameter of the punty after we break it off. But if it, the most crucial thing is for it to sit in there in a somewhat centered manner so it pulls well, you know? Even if it's a slight miss, it'll find center on its own with the weight. But it'll look a little more elegant if, you know. It's the plumb bob, it's gotta be true. Right. More filling the negative void, you know? Yep. I like the booster seat on the bench here. What's that?
Hold on, that's 7.5 inch.
Yeah. So we're going to try to push the boundaries, break the rules a bit today. We're going to blow a nice, pure, clean form, and then attempt to suspend it from the ceiling using this pulley system to my left. It'll become self-evident what we do, or when we do it. I would be really thrilled. Well, let's see. Let's start off with, I'd be happy if it made it 5 minutes. I'd be getting a little bit giddy if it made it to 15 minutes. And I'd be stoked if it made it all day. If it self-anneals, it'll be all right with me. But there are a lot of variables. I've got a good team behind me. I feel like we're going to pull this off. How you doing, Miss Courtney? Very good. Okay. Cool. It does feel good to be like just have my hand a little, my shoulder over the pipe. Yeah. No, that's a good solution because you just went through the cracks, right? Yeah. Yep, perfect. To everyone that's just tuning in, this is Courtney Dodd. Making my life easier every day. We'll take one skinny gather on this. So I'm a little bit tempted to go with this amount of material, but I think if we take a skinny on there, we can blow up the scale a bit more. Of course, if I make this piece wafer thin, my chances of it surviving longer are much greater, but I'll probably make a much more elegant form if I maintain my comfort level with the amount of material. So just because we're on camera doesn't mean you can't ask questions. So go ahead, you know. Cool. If I was making these for the water-filled plumb bobs, I'd try to melt the bubble out entirely from the tip. So that they become sediment traps when they, if anything's in the water. Not that it's impossible to clean, but very difficult for sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can strip it pretty hard, Courtney. Now I know how my friends at Tacoma feel. They're on candid camera every day. Well, I guess they are here too now. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I don't even think they, no. When I went out for a hot lunch residency, I was definitely thinking about it. All right, there I am. It's all right. Courtney stripped most of the material off in the furnace, which is good. I'm not wasting material. I see how I made the egg form on that last touch. This way we won't come back to squat form if she really rifles the heat. What were you gonna say, sir? Yeah, that way you can push in the tip and it won't push back on your pipe. You know what I mean? You're working with and against gravity at the same time. Yeah. Hello, please, sir. Hello, please, sir. Bit, please. Doors, please. Yeah, it's going to go through a bit of a process to get that cylinder on top of the sphere shape. So, it's my little insurance policy. Well, it depends on how you weight your color. Hello, please. It's also a matter of habit. When I make these at home, they hang from cables going through that center of the glass, so try to give it some structure. Hello, please. Okay. Jackline, please. Right. Then I let it blow out a little more evenly, for sure. Turn like you were on the internet. Letting it go, it's looking good. Okay. Blow, please. So for everybody in my class, again, every time I change directions, I'm centering the bubble. Blow, please. Lovely. So at this point, I stopped blowing. I have a substantial amount of thickness out here. And if I kept blowing, that's the place that has the heat now. And that's where my bubble would travel. I'm going to leave the sphere fairly undeveloped and establish the cylinder on the top. And then I'll just work on the top portion of the hemisphere. I like to dance in and out of the fire a little bit so I don't get a sharp heat line. Go for one more overall, please. So I'm elongating this shape a good bit because when I go to squeeze in the cylindrical top, it'll squat up my form. So I'm kind of preempting it by making it longer than it needs to be. It's also much easier to pull a portion of that glass out of the mass. If it's elongated, if it's squat, you know, you have nothing to grab onto. Thank you. I had the heat to go after it, but I was a little off center, so I decided to wait. You can leave them, it's fine. Thank you. Thanks for working the doors, guys. Every time I go to teach somewhere, I get so spoiled with all these assistants. So I start squeezing that cylinder in at the base and work my way out. Yeah, really good right there. Thank you. Blow a little bit, please. Okay. Full thing, please. You know how we were talking about your hand burning? Oh. This helps sometimes. Blow, please. Blow. Next time. Again, the whole thing. Blowing, please. stopping. What's that? Yeah, the Ray flat plane, yeah. Exactly. All right, and again. So really just concerning myself with the top half of the form right now. If it starts to get thin, would one of you guys paper the tip? Will do. Just a whisper, please. I'll let you keep an eye on it, actually. All right. Just blow a little bit, please. Lovely. I like how this is, you know, ever so slightly over-accentuated. I think that's a nice moment right there. Want to start a punty? You guys make sure the mid-range is fired up. Either way. Is that visible? I'll stop and flip for you, or if you want me to keep turning, that's fine. Have you guys used tungsten tips before? Stopping, flipping, turning. After you get through, go ahead and open it up some more. When you blow a big volume like this, and you're using blow punties, on large volumes like this, I like to open up the tungsten hole a little bit. It lets air go in and out with pace. If it's too small and you come out of a hot hole, air contracts, your piece will collapse. I'll take a look. Especially if your wall thicknesses are getting thinner. I think we're good right now. Let's see. Yeah, we're fine. Yeah, got it in. Thank you, sir. Yeah, that's great. Thank you. Did that make sense? Did I finish the explanation? So many times I've finished a piece or I've gotten really close and my wall thickness, you know, it's gotten thin, and I'll come out and the form will collapse and I'll have to blow it back up. And it looks good. And I'll go back in. So don't torture yourself like that. You gotta have that little door open or closed just a little bit. Your bubble, Chris. Awesome. That's the way these days, right? Probably looks better on the television screen. Well, on the phone. How you doing, Miss Courtney? No rush, we've got to fill the hour, remember? Okay. Yep. We've got some good heat, so a little bit. I'm very adept at putting dome punties on center, but blow punties and crown punties, I'm pretty good at missing the shot. Chris, weight down the pipe, please. Stopping, flipping. Support it. Blow, please. Blow through, please.
More line, please.
More line. Good. Was it going through? Good. If my piece is moving and I need to center it, I'll stop with the high point up and then pick the punty up instead of pushing it down. A little bit, please. Thank you. I think it's about as centered as it ever was. Just one. She only needs one.
Close.
Just say.
Open the big one on the left.
Left only.
Open the little one on the right.
There you go. All right. Two doors, like some
building.
Yeah, if we have it. Thank you, sir. Too kind.
Thank you.
Well, I think for right now, you never have to open your big guy. Just the left one. Down, please. Lovely. Plenty. It's a little hot in the back. No, it's fine. Who in the house likes clear glass? I'm a fan. The only thing I disagreed with Mr. Bill Gutenrath on in our tour was I'm actually not a fan of the twinkle that lead glass has. The twinkle toes. Sometimes I am. But I like the muted quality of soda lime clear glass. Maybe Spruce Pine heard that, they'll give me some free batch. You can close the left big one. Open left. Close, please. Thank you. So now that I've somewhat established that tip, I'm going to start building the heat up to the rear of the form. Almost impossible to see that little tip in there, so I'm trying to be mindful. A little lightly, please. Stopping. Long flash, we'll torch it one more time. Lost our curve.
Yeah,
But we'll get it back. I have faith. From when we hung it down the first time. Whole thing, whole time. I'm gonna torch it one more time. A little lightly. Stopping. Take all doors on the way out. Open. Blowing, please. Blowing hard like the wind. Slowing down, stopping, turning. Looks pretty good, huh? Just clean up the tip. Just a baby flash. So this is what I was talking about. When the wall thickness gets this thin, the volume gets this big, a lot of air has to go in and out really quickly. Anyway, yes. That's how I got my big break, guys, swinging doors. Blow hard. Stopping. Do about that. Open. Glad I'm not any shorter. Go ahead and torch this hard. That little area. Okay. Knock it. I got it. in the glory hole back in a minute, please, somebody. What's that? Sure. Thank you. Yes. Close. Thank you. Coming out. Taking baby flashes on this because it is so thin. Okay. I'm gonna pass this off to you, Courtney. Just in and out flashes. We're gonna make that line a little bit thinner. Probably be okay to just give it a light torch right as I'm coming over. You'll be okay to just give it a light torch. I'm gonna, yeah. Thank you, sir. Okay, who's on teardrop duty? Placing it in there? Are you, Courtney? Flash, please. You can go ahead and hang it there for, you know. I didn't put much of a jack line in here in my punty, so I'm dealing with that now. Any movement at all? Huh? Yeah. Hang it a little bit. Put a nice thread in there. Okay. You don't have to go all the way in if you don't have the ability to right now. Turn out front. So in just a minute, you're going to get that tip glowing, right? All right, the ball is yours, Courtney. Okay, thank you. Yeah. Getting there. Almost ready for that bit. Oh, thank you.
Yes.
So just give it three good chomps with the duck bills, and then we'll knock it off. Sure. Yeah, you could. When I'm on my way over, it won't remember it was hot for very long. All right. Let's take that mid-range over there. Moment of truth. What's gonna happen? I see an angel tear. I see a perfect bit. A lovely application. That's great. That's plenty. Yep. You're fine for a second. Stabilize that. Yep. All right. Did the pulley come down any further?
Can we go down? Yeah.
Bring the bucket over. Down with the pulley a little bit.
Down, please.
No, no, yeah, we're good. Go ahead and start drawing up, please. Draw, draw, draw. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Slowly now. That's a good diameter right there. Yeah, it's great. Keep going. Now go fast. Courtney, it's fine. Let it be. Keep going. Go faster now. Yeah, that's good. Oh, let it come down again. Up a little bit. Oh. All right, let's go down so it's almost touching the floor. And then we can tie it off. Anybody start a stopwatch? Sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just trying not to shake it. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not going to be able to tie it without shaking it. You good? Here, I'll just hold it here. Yeah. Got about 2.5 inches, 3 inches. Okay. 1 minute. I'm smiling. If we just had a clamp, we could. I know, we were shaking it a lot. Noble effort, team, noble effort. So I think what we should have done is pulled out a really strong, long stringer, like pure and perfect, map gassed it or torched it and stuck it right in the tungsten hole. Might have been the least amount of stress. I don't know. Anyway, that was fun, guys. Thank you.